In this presentation, I will talk about one of the most important biophysical technique required in biotechnology industry and research purpose, that is microscopy. So this presentation will cover the basics of microscopy and types of microscopy and their use. Introduction part. A biophysical technique which is used to study the objects and its areas which cannot be seen through naked eye. For example, microorganisms like bacteria and yeast and cells like cancer cells and blood cells, types of blood cells. A microscope consists of lens or combination of lenses for making enlarged or magnified images of minute objects. The ability of microscope to detect, resolve and image the smallest atoms of evidence, which often without any destruction or alteration. The aim of any microscope is to magnify images or photos of a small object and to see the fine details and study them. There are various types of microscopy. Some of them are bright field microscopy, dark field microscopy, phase contrast microscopy, fluorescent microscopy, electron transmission electron microscopy, and scanning electron microscopy. So here I will explain all these types of microscopy in this presentation. But first, let's have a look at the light microscope or compound microscope. A compound microscope has two set of lenses. One is objective lens and another one is eyepiece. So the lens which is nearest to the specimen is objective lens, which magnifies the image, and other lens which is nearest to the eye called eyepiece, which further magnifies the image formed by the objective. So there are also fine adjustment screws which are used to attain the proper focusing of the specimen which is under study. So the parts of compound microscope are objective lenses, eyepiece and condensers. So the objective lenses, which they gather light rays coming from any point to the object, and they unite the light in a point which is further to magnify the image. There are three types of objective lenses. First one is achromatic one, which is simplest and adequate for most of the purpose. Fluorides are those in which the aberrations are largely eliminated by the use of achromatic ones. So aberration meaning the failure of rays to converge at one focus because of a defect in a lens or a mirror. Apochromatic, which is corrected with respect to the aberrations. Eyepiece. The main use of the eyepiece, they magnify the real image of the specimen which is under study, which are formed by the objective lenses, and with the help of fine adjustment they will correct the defects in the objective. And eyepieces are also called as oculars. There are three types of eyepieces: Hagenian, hyperplex and compensating eyepieces. Condensers, a series of lenses for illumination to the object on the stage of microscope by transmitted light. There are two methods. One is illumination by transmitted light and other one is dark field illumination. Resolving power. It is defined as the power of an objective which is able to distinguish two adjacent points. Resolving power of a microscope is a function of wavelength of light used and the numerical aperture of the lens system. Larger the numerical aperture, greater the resolving power. Numerical aperture, the sine value of the half aperture angle multiplied by the refractive index of the medium, which gives the numerical aperture. With the dry objectives, the value of the refractive index is 1, because 1 is the refractive index of air. But when immersion oil is used as a medium, then the refractive index will be 1.56. So in the relation is numerical aperture equal to refractive index into sine theta. Theta is an angle. Limit of resolution. The limit of resolution can be defined as the smallest distance between two separate objects, which can be distinguished as two separate objects. The greater resolution in light microscopy is obtained with the shortest wavelength of visible light and an objective with maximum numerical aperture. So the relation can be expressed as resolution equal to wavelength divided by 2 times numerical aperture. Magnification of a microscope is the increase in size of the object. So, and one more thing is that the magnification beyond resolving power, which has no value. Bright field microscopy. The microscope field is bright and the microorganisms or specimen which are under study, they appear dark because they absorb some of the light. Staining the specimens or microorganisms greatly increases their absorbing ability and which produces the fine and good image of the specimen. For example, HND staining, which is hematoxylin and eosin staining, in which hematoxylin stains the nuclei of the cell and eosin stains the cytoplasm. You can see the example of the image HND staining, the upper right corner. And generally, the microscope of this type of microscopy produces useful magnification of about 1000x to 2000x. So this type of microscopy is also called as transmitted light. It has transillumination light as a source, light source, usually the halogen lamp, and it has a condenser lens which focuses light into the sample, an objective lens which collects the light from the sample and magnifies the image, eyepiece or a camera to view the sample image. And bright field microscope is very simple to set up and required for all the basic imaging, which makes it basic equipment required in research purpose. And limitations of this type of microscopy are that they are very low construct of the most biological samples, and it has practical limit to the magnification. And beyond 2000x, the image become fuzzy or it appears blur, and samples that are colorless and transparent, which cannot be imaged properly, although you can enhance the brightness of the image by reducing or increasing the light source. Using an oil immersion objective lens for some specific specimens, and using sample staining methods, for example hematoxylin, eosin staining. Dark field microscopy. In dark field microscopy, the microscope field is dark. That means a dark background is produced against which objects are brilliantly illuminated. It is like opposite of bright field microscopy. So in this microscopy, they are used to enhance the contrast in the unstained samples. For example, in this image, you can see the fibers appear bright and the background for that appears dark. The light microscope, which is equipped with a special kind of condenser that transmits a hollow core of light from the source of illumination, and illuminating from the source of illumination, right? And then illuminating an object where the object appears self-luminous against the dark field is called dark field illustration. So there are three types of condenser which are used in dark field microscopy: Abbe condenser, parabolite condenser, and cardioid condenser. This type of microscopy is particularly valuable for unstained samples, and this is also used in hanging drop operations. Phase contrast microscopy. Light passing from one object into another object of a slightly different refractive index or thickness undergoes a change in phase. So according to the principle of phase contrast microscopy, the light waves have variable character for frequency and amplitude. When two light rays have similar amplitude and frequency but different phases, then this type of microscopy is used to image the specimen. So it is used to visualize unstained living cells. Most of the stains or staining processor will kill the cells, but the phase contrast microscopy enables the visualization of the living cells. So in a phase contrast microscope, the difference in phase is translated into variation in brightness of the image, and hence it is detectable by eye. With a phase contrast microscope, the differences among various cells with different refractive indices or thickness can be seen in an unstained condition. A phase contrast microscope is a compound microscope fitted with a phase contrast condenser and a phase contrast objective. An annular aperture in the diaphragm placed in the focal plane of the substage condenser controls the illumination of the objective. The image of the aperture is formed at the rear focal plane of the objective. And in this plane, there is a phase shifting element or phase plate. The phase plate also has an annular ring of phase altering pattern, which can increase the wavelength of light passing through it. So the light coming through the annular aperture of the condenser passes through the object, and those rays which are not deviated by the objective pass through the phase altering pattern of the phase plate and acquire the longer wavelength. So those rays which are deviated by the object object structures due to the different refractive index pass through the face plate, which are not covered by the phase altering pattern. Thus, their wavelength remains unchanged. The difference in phase gives the contrast for clear visibility of the object. Fluorescent microscopy. The fluorescence is the emission of light by a substance that has absorbed light or other electromagnetic radiation. So, to fluoresce to occur, the substance must absorb light at a shorter wavelength and then emit the light at longer wavelength. I mean, when the substance is at the ground state is excited by a light source, for example laser, it will absorb some of the light at shorter wavelength and they emit light at a different wavelength or longer wavelength. A fluorescent microscope uses fluorescence or phosphorescence. Any microscope that uses fluorescence to generate an image is fluorescent microscope. So the simplest ones are the epifluorescent microscope, which is simple to set up and very simple to use. There are more complicated fluorescent microscopes are available. For example, confocal microscope, which uses optical sectioning to get the better resolution of the fluorescence image by reducing the background and all. So the components of a typical epifluorescent microscope are light source, usually xenon lamp or mercury vapor lamp, and excitation filter, dichroic mirror, and emission filters. For example, the light source will emit white light and excitation filter will only pass the light required, in this case here blue light, which will hit the dichroic mirror placed in front of the excitation filter, and the blue light will travel through the objective lens to the specimen. The specimen will observe the blue light and emit the green light. This green light will travel through the specific emission filter to the oculars, and then detectors will capture this green light, and the camera which is placed near the detector will capture this green light emitted with the green light emitted and forms the image. And this which can be used in immunofluorescence, where specific antibodies are tagged with the fluorophore molecule, which will emit the fluorescence when bound to specific antigens. And there are fluorescent proteins available. And major limitation of fluorescent microscopy is that the photo bleaching, because the fluorophores lose their ability to fluoresce as they are illuminated in a process. So that is why if you want to perform a fluorescent imaging, then you should perform the imaging very fast. So, but it doesn't apply to all the fluorescent molecules. There are some fluorophores which are stable and stay fluorescent for quite some time. But remember, the fluorescent microscope is the most used imaging technique in biological research, as it allows you to study the fine details of the cells, for example, its nucleus, cells, proteins, cell structures and other components of the cells. In the next presentation, we'll talk about electron microscopy, transmission electron microscopy, and scanning electron microscopy.